Hi Muckers, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I have an incredibly messy one for you today, and I have a story time on how I was able to do it. So if you're aware by the title or the thumbnail on this, this is not clickbait. Unfortunately, this did happen, and it happened like an hour or so ago. Let's get to the point. I went on the Wendy Williams show and talked about Trisha and Moses. More specifically, asked for advice on Trisha and Moses. And now, I do want to clarify. Trisha Paytas is going through this like manifestation era, and Trisha said 2 weeks ago that she was manifesting being on the Wendy Williams show. So I'm basically like the fairy godmother because I granted that manifestation. However, Trisha, you do not know the power of your manifestations because it wasn't you hosting, it was me asking for advice on your behalf. Basically that I was your friend. Yes, I literally have the ticket, the Wendy Williams show. So to get tickets to the Wendy Williams show, if anyone's interested, again, I know everyone's mixed opinions on Wendy. She's not hosting right now. She's off on sick leave. And I mean, like, little spoiler, we had to go on a lift up to the studio, and the security team were like kind of like talking shit about Wendy. Like, someone was like, I can't wait for Wendy to come back. And the security team started laughing and they were like, when Wendy comes back. Which is sad because it's her show and she's really, really, really sick right now. But that's not the point of the video. But I do just want to let you know, if anyone likes the Wendy Williams show out there, there was some shady conversations happening. However, it was a great experience. The staff were great. The producers were great. Everyone was great about it. And I've been on the Wendy Williams show twice before, virtually. Let me show you that real quick before I get into this messy story time. So I was on initially, oh, this one was the first one actually, where I was the virtual audience member. So here I am with Miss Wendy. This was in my bedroom in Ireland. And then I was on for a second time right before I left for Brighton. So I've been on the show twice. However, I've never physically been on the show, but I was today. So you have to get your tickets in advance. This was the only show day that was available, so I quickly grabbed it. I got tickets for me and mom. We went there, we had to wake up at 6 a.m. and we had to be there for 7, we were queuing. Then we got in, we got our tickets, we got our Vax pass checked, and it was fun. So we went in, went through security in like this like garage, and we were in the waiting area, and they specifically were like, if anyone has any questions for Ask Wendy, there's gonna be a guest host on, but we would love to hear them. And I immediately was like, I have nothing interesting going on in my life, but I think it might be funny to, with some of the drama that we're talking about on YouTube, maybe like tweak it so it's like my life to make me sound more interesting. And I immediately popped into my head the full Trisha and Moses. They just got married and I'm like, oh, the full cat drama, the full Moses with the family and Trisha with the family. And I was like, hold on, because it doesn't sound real. Like, I talk about it on YouTube and it sounds so insane every single day. So I was like, maybe the producers will love this. So I wrote it down on the piece of paper. It was like, if you have a question, write it here. I said something quite in detail. Actually, I filled out like half a page briefly talking about it. And they ended up calling out my name and I'm sitting with my mom and I'm like, oh fuck, I submitted that as a joke. And if you're like, oh, you shouldn't have just submitted something. No. They make every single person submit something. And I was like, oh, this will be funny. You know, someone else has something better. And then they're like, Adam McIntyre from Ireland. And I'm like, oh my fucking God. So I go to the backstage area and they're like briefing everyone. They screen your questions. So they basically have you one-on-one with the producer. You have to take off your mask so they can see your face if they want you on TV. And then, oh, we also got these wristbands. This is Wendy. They ask us in more detail about the question that we have. We ask basically everything to do with the surroundings of your question, and if they were to ask more in detail about it, they were also doing that. So the producer was doing that, and then they screened our questions to see if like they wanted it on TV. And I was like, oh, at this stage they're not gonna do it, because I went up and I basically said about Trisha, I said about Moses, I said about Ethan, I said about Ela, but I was just relating it that they were my friends because I was like, they would answer it if it's that. But it was such a crazy story that I was like, oh, they're not gonna do it. You know, they're gonna screen it and it's not gonna go through. So then we go back and they're like, okay, we finally screened the ones that we wanna see. So they cut the list down from like 12 people to like 5 people. And they're like, they call out the names and then they go, and Adam McIntyre. And I literally turned to my mom like this. So then I go forward. And again, you have to say more detail about it to the producer. They screen it. And then they give you this little sheet. And we only had this for like 5 minutes because they didn't want us like religiously going off of this. But it's basically the key points to get to in your story without the names involved. So this is what they gave to the host, who is Michael something, who was Phoebe's cop boyfriend in Friends. You'll see when I show you the clip. So this is what he got from what I was going to say. So he got this in advance. All the producers had this. They had my full thing. So they were aware. It says, "Hey, I'm Adam, 19, from Ireland. Recently, a friend got married to a woman that is ruining our friendship. He's completely changed and is told to spend less time with us and our friends. I think she's jealous when he spends time with anyone other than us. Should I talk to the friend or let him go?" So this was the really brief one. And then they said, when you get up there, give more detail. So again, just to kind of brief you, there were five people who were sitting down in this specific area so that they could go up to the mic. And then fast forward throughout the show, maybe 30 minutes into the show is when they do the asking segment. So all five of us were supposed to speak. And the woman in front of me goes, "Really entertaining." And then I go up and I'm like, fuck. So I go up then and I say my question, and it's going on for a bit longer than I anticipated. I'll show you the clip, but it goes on for a little bit longer than I was thinking. And then I walk off to the side and the person behind me comes up. And then they only do us three because basically he spent so much time on each of us whenever they normally do like 20 minute like quick questions. So the rest of the people, sorry to y'all, but our questions were just too jizzy that they focused on us. I'm joking. I'm actually not though. This is the truth. So I'm going to show you the clip now. Again, this was our ticket. Really easy process of getting tickets, by the way. They basically want people to show because right now for the Wendy Williams show, they're in a bit of a hotspot because Wendy is, you know, has been off for so long on sick leave. And, you know, normally the appeal of a show is the person who's hosting it. And, you know, you book tickets to the show. They're free, by the way, without knowing who the guest host is. Someone called Sherry Shepherd was supposed to host, and then she went into hospital last night. So this guy stepped in. And again, I didn't know who he was until I left the building. And then I looked him up online and realized that he was in Atypical and in Friends, which is what I cared about. So I'm going to show you the clip right now. But again, first of all, I want to note that Trisha has tweeted, "Yo, Wendy Williams, when you retire, can I get your gig? Wendy Williams show needs to call me." And then quoted the tweet that said that Wendy was sick and needs someone to step in for the show. And Trisha said, "I'm ready to step in at Wendy Williams." So again, I am the godmother. I'm the fairy godmother who is answering and granting wishes. Trisha, you're welcome. So let me show you the clip. It is pretty brief, but pretty juicy. And online is like freaking out. And also, 30 minutes before the show went up was whenever I found out that I was actually going to be on it. I tweeted out really quickly, and a lot of you were watching and sending me pictures, and I was like, on your TV. And I was like, oh my God. I didn't think about it until the moment I stood up that I was actually going to be on TV throughout national TV throughout America. So if you saw me today or your parents saw me, hey. So let me show you the clip. I do need to preface, the guy is so far away from you and you're in the audience. It doesn't look good on camera because of the camera's right in front of you. It's right in front of him, but we're very far away from each other. So immediately whenever I went up, you can't hear him. He doesn't have a mic on. So he's basically not even shouting. He's just talking. So you cannot hear him. And the crowd were like clapping because each person stands up, whatever. That's just what they do in a niceties. So he said, what's your name? What's your age? And where are you from? But because I couldn't hear him, the first thing I heard him say was the last thing, which was, where are you from? So I immediately went up and said, hi, Ireland. And then realized that midway through that he asked for my name first. So you'll see, there was a little bit of miscommunication. I go, hi, I'm Ireland, Adam. Just had to clarify that, but I think I saved myself pretty good. Let me show you this. So this is me asking the guest host on the Wendy Williams show on live TV what I should do. You know, my friend Moses got married to this woman, Trisha, and, you know, she took away his cats and she's just causing turmoil on the friends and I need help. I'm just so shocked that this got through the screening process because there was a couple muckers in the audience. Someone posted a picture of me sitting in the audience from like a couple of rows back and we're like, hey, I spotted Adam. And I'm like, and then another person when we were outside came up to me and they were like, Adam, can we get a picture? So shout out to you. Your name was Trey. Love you so much. But there were muckers in the audience. And there was a guy beside my mom who knew H3 and immediately turned to my mom and was like, I know what he's talking about. So this is me on the Wendy Williams Show asking for help. You know, I'm really concerned for my friend Moses. Here we go.
Question, what's your name? Where are you from? What's your question for me?
Hi, I'm Ireland, or I'm Adam, from Ireland, 19. I need your help desperately. My friend group is falling apart because my friend Moses got married to that woman. We know, Trisha, yeah. And they've only been dating for less than a year, and she is obsessive. She's taking him away. She made him get rid of his cats because... Yep, she made him get rid of the cats because she was spending too much time with that. And us as well, my question is, should we be getting rid of him? What should we be doing? How do we confront this?
Okay, well, it sounds like are you really from Ireland? Because that's a suspect Ireland accent.
Excuse me? I let it slide. I was like, I'm not going to start a fight on TV. Excuse me? Like, into the mic? No, I get that a lot.
You know what I would say? Listen, you gotta let him do his thing. It sounds like this woman is domineering, but you can't help save or fix the situation. Be supportive and wish him nothing but the best.
Moses, I wish you nothing but the best.
Where are the cats? Where are the cats at? That's the question I got for you. Where are the cats at?
Gone.
I do want to state, though, we've talked about Catgate. If you're not aware, basically, Trisha was jealous that Moses was going back to his house to look after his cats and thought something else was going on, and was jealous that he was spending time with them over her, even if he was just going to feed them. And then he ended up getting rid of them. So I did want to bring that up. So now people are like doing the like sound bite of him being like, where are the cats? And it's like, we've been asking this question. And someone was like, it was not in my 2021 bingo for Adam McIntyre to go on the Wendy Williams Show and ask about Trisha and Moses, but furthermore, for the guest host to be like, where are the cats on national TV? So for one final time, let's watch it, and then we will end off the video. So here we go. This is your mucker on the Wendy Williams Show.
Question, what's your name? Where are you from? What's your question for me?
Hi, I'm Ireland, or I'm Adam, from Ireland, 19. I need your help desperately. My friend group is falling apart because my friend Moses...
I'm gonna get such backlash for this. This is gonna come bite me in the ass. The producers are gonna come find me. Do it.
Married to that woman.
By the way, if you don't know what that means, Wendy Williams used to always go that woman for like a really shady woman. She used to always call Kris Jenner that woman. It would always be like a that woman. So I need to get that in. And so it was the producers and Suzanne, who's kind of like the person who hypes up the crowd, who was like, what? So listen, I was feeding off of the participation of others and I was living. Okay, here we go.
Friend Moses got married to that woman. We know, Trisha, yeah, and they've only been dating for less than a year, and she is obsessive, she's taking him away, she made him get rid of his cats because, yep, she made him get rid of the cats because she was spending too much time with that, and us as well, my question is, should we be getting rid of him? What should we be doing? How do we confront this?
Okay, well, it sounds like...
By the way, this point right here, I didn't realize the camera was still on me right here. Okay. What is the... Do you have the answer? Like, fuck me, Jesus. Oi.
Well, it sounds like you... Are you really from Ireland? Because that's a suspect Ireland accent.
I'm so hurt by that comment.
Actually, I am. All right, you know what I would say? Listen, you gotta let him do his thing. It sounds like this woman is domineering, but you can't help... save or fix the situation. Be supportive and wish him nothing but the best. Where are the cats? Where are the cats at? That's the question I got for you. Where are the cats at?
Gone.
All right, well, just...
And with that being said, it's time for Adam to leave America. I cannot be trusted here. Okay, well, come on, give you a little story time, tell you about it. I've seen people, like, tag me to talk about it, and I immediately wanted to come on first to tell you the muckers. So... I think it's time for me to leave America. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.